Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, you'll learn all about remarketing in Google Ads. Remarketing can help increase conversions coming from your campaigns. We're going to walk through the steps to set up remarketing, plus we'll cover three mistakes you can avoid to get the most out of your remarketing campaigns. Remarketing lets you show ads to people who've already engaged with your business. Once you've created an audience list, you can use it with your search, display, performance max, and other types of campaigns in your account. We're going to walk through the steps to create audience lists for remarketing in Google Analytics and Google Ads. To start, let's head to Google Ads. You can create audience lists in Google Ads using the Google tag from your Google Ads account, or by importing an audience from Google Analytics. If you're already using Google Analytics, this is the easiest way to start a remarketing campaign. Using Google Analytics also provides additional flexibility in how you can include or exclude people from your audience list. We're going to look at both options, and we're going to start with Google Analytics. Before we begin, we need to make sure Google Analytics is linked to your Google Ads account. To check this, we select Tools, and then Data Manager. You will then be able to see if Google Analytics is linked to your account. Here we can see Google Analytics has been linked to Google Ads, which means we're ready to start creating our audience lists. If Google Analytics isn't linked to your Google Ads account, I've included a link to my dedicated tutorial in the description below this video. It's important to link your accounts correctly, otherwise you won't see your audience lists in Google Ads. Since the accounts are linked, let's head to Google Analytics. We're in my Google Analytics demo property, and to create an audience list to use in Google Ads, we need to navigate to Admin. And then select Audiences. Or we can select Data Display on the left, and then Audiences. This lets us view any existing audience lists and create new ones. Google Analytics automatically creates a list for all users. And if you're tracking e-commerce transactions, you will also see a list that includes people who've made a purchase. These lists are automatically created for us by default. And we can see any existing custom audience lists that have been created. Okay, now let's create a new list. Let's select New Audience. We can now create our audience list from scratch or use one of the pre-built lists. These are designed to provide starting points and suggestions for audiences. Plus, you can also find the predictive audiences you can create. These are all based on Google's AI, or machine learning, to predict what users are likely to do on your website. We can see these are all listed as not eligible to use for my demo property because I don't have enough users for Google to make predictions. We will build our audience from scratch, so let's select Create a Custom Audience at the top. Let's create an audience list that includes people who viewed product pages on my website but didn't purchase. This will let us target ads to people who visited my website and viewed a product in Google Ads. You can create an audience list for any pages or actions you've tracked into Google Analytics. We're going to use pages to build our audience list because if you're not looking after an e-commerce store, this is easy to adjust for any other type of website. But I want to highlight that you could also use the View Item event if you are tracking this into your property. Okay, let's name the audience Viewed Product Pages. Now let's add a condition. Let's search for Page Path. And let's select the Page Path and Screen Class option. We will use this to match the product pages on our website. The Page Path and Screen Class dimension includes everything after the domain name on our website, but doesn't include any query parameters added to the end of our URLs. Now let's select Add Filter. Let's change the matching from contains to begins with. And now let's enter /product/. And let's click Apply. This will mean that anybody viewing a page on our website where the page starts with /product/ will be included in our audience list. Feel free to adjust the page path or even the condition for your audience list. You can use any of the available dimensions and metrics to include people in your list. And here's a common mistake to avoid. Don't make your audience list too precise. If your list only includes a handful of people, your ads might not be displayed, and you won't see a return on the time it takes to create and manage the campaign. Now let's select Add Group to Exclude. By default, this will temporarily exclude users based on our criteria. For example, if someone makes a purchase, they won't see any remarketing ads. However, if they later return to the website and don't make a purchase, then they might start seeing the remarketing ads again after the membership duration has passed. For my audience list, I'm going to select this and change it to Permanently Exclude Users. This means someone will be removed from the list once they've made a purchase. Now let's add a condition. And let's search for and select Purchase as the event. This means that when a purchase event occurs, that user will be removed from our audience list. Now let's click Save. The nice thing about audience lists in Google Analytics is that they are re-evaluated as people return to your website. This means if someone is included in a list and later meets the criteria to be excluded, they'll automatically be removed, and vice versa. Okay, now that we've created our audience, users will begin to be added to the list. This list will automatically become available in Google Ads, but you will need to wait until the list populates in Google Ads. This can take up to 72 hours. Let's head back to Google Ads. To see our audience lists in Google Ads, we select Tools, then Shared Library, and Audience Manager. We can now see all of our audience lists. This will include lists that have been automatically created, lists imported from Google Analytics, and any other lists that have been created in the account. Before we create a remarketing campaign in our Google Ads account, I want to show you how you can create a list using the dedicated Google Ads remarketing tag, which is called the Google tag. You can use this option if you're not using Google Analytics, you prefer to keep data separate, or you're already sending data to Google Ads using the Google tag. We need to add the remarketing tag to our website to use this option. Since we're still looking at the Audience Manager, let's click the plus sign and select Website Visitors. For this example, we will create an audience list for people who view content on our website's blog. So let's name our audience Viewed Blog. For segment members, let's ensure Visitors of Web Pages is selected. For actions, we can see we will be including people who've been to our website in the last 30 days. So let's leave this and click Refine Action on the right. Let's ensure Page URL is selected, along with Contains. And let's enter /blog/. This means anybody who views a page on our website where the URL contains /blog/ will be included in our list. Let's leave the other options and click Create Segment. We can see our audience list has been created. For people to be included in this list, we must add the Google Ads remarketing tag to our website. If you're using Google Tag Manager, you can easily add this by creating a new tag. And if you're not using Google Tag Manager, you'll need to add the Google tag to all of your website's pages. To get the tag, we select the Your Data Sources tab. look for the Google Ads tag and select Details. Scroll to the bottom, select Tag Setup. If you want to install the Google tag, you can click Install the tag yourself. Or if you're using Google Tag Manager, you can click Use Google Tag Manager. Let's copy the conversion ID. And let's head to Google Tag Manager. We're looking at the Google Tag Manager container that is already installed on my demo site. If you're just getting started with Google Tag Manager, I recommend watching my dedicated tutorials and joining my Google Tag Manager course. They cover how to get started, along with adding tags and more. I've included links in the description below this video. Let's select Add a New Tag. Let's name the tag Google Ads Remarketing. Now let's select Tag Configuration. Choose Google Ads. And select Google Ads Remarketing as the tag type. Since this is the first Google Ads tag I've added to Google Tag Manager, we can see there is an alert telling us that the conversion linker tag is missing. This tag improves the accuracy of Google Ads tracking by creating a first-party cookie in the user's browser. If you don't see this message, the tag has already been created. But since we're seeing the message, we need to create it. So let's click Create. Let's name the tag Conversion Linker. And click Save. Now we're looking at our remarketing tag again. So let's paste the conversion ID we copied from Google Ads. Let's leave the rest of the default options and let's select Triggering. Let's select the Initialization All Pages trigger. This will add the Google Ads remarketing tag to all of the pages of our website. Now let's save our tag. And let's click Submit to publish our tag to our live website. Our remarketing tag has now been added to our website. We've now covered two ways you can create audience lists. We've created an audience in Google Analytics that was imported into Google Ads and created an audience inside Google Ads. You only need to use one of these options. You don't need to use both. Just use the option that works for you. Which option are you going to use? Are you going to import audience lists from Google Analytics or create them in Google Ads? I'd love to know what you choose. Take a moment to let me know in the comments. Now let's head back to Google Ads. Once you've created your audience list, they will begin collecting details for the users you can target with your ads. Depending on the type of campaign you create, there are minimum list sizes you'll need to meet before your ads begin to show. For search and video campaigns, you'll need 1,000 people on your list. For display campaigns, you'll need at least 100 people on your list. Okay, now let's create a new remarketing campaign. Let's click Create, and then Campaign. And let's select the option to create a campaign without guidance. I'm going to create a display campaign, but you can use your audience list with other types of campaigns too. I'm going to leave all of the goals for this campaign, but you should ensure the goals selected here match the objectives you've set for your campaign. Now let's click Continue. And click Continue. Let's name the campaign. And click Continue. Since I'm setting this campaign up as a draft, I'm going to complete each of these steps quickly. For your campaign, I recommend checking through each of the settings. If you'd like to learn more about the steps to set up a campaign, I recommend watching my dedicated Google Ads tutorial and checking out my Google Ads course. Now we select our geographic targeting and click Next. We enter our daily budget and choose a bidding strategy. Then we click Next. Now we're on the targeting step, so let's click Add Targeting. Let's choose Audience Segments. You can now search for the audience list you want to use with your campaign. Or we can click Browse. Then how they have interacted with your business. And website visitors. We can now select the audience list or lists we want to use with our campaign. By default, Google Ads can automatically show your ads to people not included in your list. If you would like to disable this option, select Optimize Targeting. Then deselect Use Optimize Targeting. Now let's click Next. We're now asked to create an ad. When you create the ads in your campaign, ensure they connect with the people in your audience list. It's also a good idea to tailor the offer. For example, you could offer a special discount to people who haven't converted yet. Not adjusting ads and offers in remarketing campaigns is another common mistake. Since I'm creating a draft campaign, I'm going to create my ads later, so let's click Cancel and click Next. We can see some warnings at the top, but let's scroll to the bottom and click Publish Campaign and click Publish again. We've now created the draft for our remarketing campaign. And to check that our audience list has been applied, check that the campaign is selected at the top. Then choose Audiences, Keywords and Content. Then Audiences. We can see that our new campaign has our audience list applied. Once the list has met Google's requirements for the number of people included in the list, our ads will begin to show. Apart from using audience lists for targeting, you can also use them for reporting. This lets you see performance metrics for people included in your lists. To do this, we add our audience list as an observation. Skipping this is a common mistake and it means you'll be missing out on additional insights. Let's select another campaign. Then make sure Audiences is selected and choose Add Audience Segments. Now let's choose Campaign. And we can see Observation is selected at the top. This means we will be using our audience list for reporting. So we will be able to see campaign performance for people included in the list. Now we select our list. And click Save. We've now applied our audience list as an observation for our campaign. There are even more ways to use audience lists. You can use them to optimize Performance Max campaigns and streamline reporting in Google Analytics. So please take a moment to subscribe to this channel to learn everything else you can do with Google Ads and Google Analytics. You'll learn how to improve your campaigns and website to take your business to the next level. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.